I suggest you watch this video all the way through before you even start painting. Also, once you start painting, you're gonna need to hit pause every now and then.
We're gonna start off with a water wash to make a watercolor background. We're still gonna use our acrylic paints though. So get your canvas all wet with that sponge brush and then dip just a little bit into that blue paint seam and go across the top. You don't need any more paint for this. Just go all the way down to the bottom. The next thing you're gonna need is that napkin, and we're gonna dab off the llama. I want not to have a bunch of blue on there. You can have a little bit, it's okay. See, I did the sun a little bit there too. You can take some of your paintbrushes and also get into some of those tight places. I'm also gonna do a little bit around the ears. I'm gonna go all the way. I'm gonna make sure that I've got everything as white as I can get it, but I'm not gonna stress out about anything that's not. Now I've rolled that napkin up into a scrunchy little ball, and I'm making some texture in the background. I'm gonna go ahead and go all over that, and then I'm gonna make sure if I touch that llama in anywhere, I get some more of that blue off of there. Go ahead and take a dryer if you want. This is a heat gun, I just have it handy, and dry that background. If you don't have time for that, let it naturally dry. I'm gonna make an orange for the sun. I start off with some pink paint, and then I'm going to add the yellow paint. You know, red and yellow makes orange, so pink and yellow, that's gonna make a pastel color orange. Mix up just a small amount at a time. You don't want to use a whole bunch of paint for this. You don't want to mix all your paint because it's not a very big area that you need that orange. I don't want you to be real worried about your edges. Do the best you can. We are going to take like a Sharpie pen and go around and outline everything. So if you don't have perfect edges, that Sharpie outline is really going to make up the difference there, and you won't be able to tell. So don't get too precise, just do your very best. Now that you have your first layer of orange on there, let's go on to the ears. We're just gonna take that straight yellow and do both the inside and the outside of the ears. Be a little bit careful around that hair, but you know what? If you make a mistake, that's okay. Pink's gonna go on top of it and it's gonna cover it up. We'll come back to that sun later. Go ahead and do both ears the same way, same color. Make sure you close the cap on that yellow, open up the pink, and we're gonna go ahead and get started with the hair. We've got that smaller brush now, and you can just use the side of the brush, use it more vertical, and you can get some really tight lines there. Go all the way through and do the hair, all pink. You're not going to get this done on the first coat. This is going to look really, really streaky. Don't worry about that at all. We'll put more colors on there. At any time, turn your canvas around to make it easier for your hand. Everybody prefers, you know, a certain way and a certain direction to paint, whether you're right-handed or left-handed. So make sure you turn your painting as needed. You're gonna really wanna watch that you don't get your hand in any of the paint that you've already got on there though. While you have pink on your brush, let's go ahead and get those areas on the cactus that we want pink. I'm gonna go ahead and mix up some more orange paint. I put about 4 dabs of the pink, and then I'm gonna put, looks like 3 dabs, maybe 4. Yeah, even amount, 4 dabs of yellow. So half and half to make up that color. After mixing that up, we're going to go ahead and put the second coat on the sun. Mine's off the camera just a little bit there.
Now I'm going to move over to the cactus and paint the orange areas on the cactus on either side of that pink that we did. We're going to go back to the yellow and paint the muzzle. Go ahead and get a nice coat on there, but it doesn't have to be, you know, complete coverage. We can go ahead and do another coat later on. While I've got yellow on my brush, I'm going to go ahead and give his hair some highlights. Now, in the end, I might not have done this. I don't know if I really liked it or not. So if you don't think that you want these highlights, don't do them. We'll just do another coat of pink. Now, in mine, there's nothing wrong with the highlights. I just think his hair should have been a nice bold pink. I don't want you to get disturbed if you do this, that, oh no, his hair is orange. Now that pink is dry, but, and definitely don't try to do this if it's wet, but we're gonna put some more pink on there and just leave little bits of the yellow showing as highlights. So if you do this and you say, oh my goodness, it's orange, it won't be orange when we're done later. Once you get all that hair done, we're going to move on to his neck. And we're just going to use that straight purple. We're going to do his whole neck in that straight purple. Again, you might have some streaks. We're going to go back and do a second coat. So don't worry about that. You'd rather go back to do the second coat, because if you try to glob this paint on there, you're just going to keep wiping it off. You're going to get really frustrated. Do a thin coat. Do another thin coat once it's dry. If you need to do a third, do a third, but I'm pretty sure I got mine done in two. Now I'm back to that orange and I'm filling in some little areas around his nose. Go ahead and do that, and then we'll meet back on the other side. After making sure that the purple is dry and the yellow is nice and dry, I want to go and use that orange on his bottom lip. I want that to stand out from his muzzle. I'm using straight blue for his eyelids. This is, again, you're not going to get this in the first coat. Put a thin coat on, let it dry, and then go back and put more coats as needed. Again, you can use the side of your brush, or you can use it horizontally like I'm doing there, like you normally do with the brush to get the bigger areas. But I turn it vertical like that to get the tinier areas. It's a lot easier that way. And I try to use the biggest brush that I possibly can use. You really only have two choices with your kit, but I'm sure you have other paintbrushes at home. If you want to move to a smaller brush and you have one, you can. That's okay. Now we're gonna need to mix up some paint. I've got a blob of white paint on there. I shouldn't have put so much. I'm gonna use about 5 dabs of white, and then I'll have 1 dab of the purple paint. I'm gonna mix it up really, really good and then start painting the face. I wanna make sure that everything that I did on the face is nice and dry. If I'm side by side with any color that's wet, I could mess it up. And it's just easier. Take that blow dryer and blow it dry, or go take a break, have a cookie, and come back once it's dry. Got my paint all mixed up, and at this time, don't put a lot of paint on your brush. Really never put a lot of paint on your brush. Start off with a little, otherwise you'll get a lot of paint in your paint strokes that is more raised because there's more paint. I've used the side of my brush here, and like I said earlier, you can use a smaller brush if you have one, but you can see you don't really need to, just depending on how you use that brush. Also, don't be real critical of yourself about the lines. We are going to go back in with that Sharpie, and that's going to make things crisp. And go ahead and do this whole face in that light lavender color. While you still have lavender on your brush, do the insides of the ears. That bright color really stands out, and I want to dull that color inside of his ears because the insides are farther away. This will kind of make a muted color for the inside of his ears. Then later you're going to see that I course correct and I paint the other side with just the straight purple. It looked a little bit weird to me that he had yellow ears on the outsides and a purple face and a purple neck. But you know what? That yellow, it really makes the purple glow on his ears. So, you know, that kind of mistake really isn't a mistake. It's just a course correction. Now that his ears are done, you can go ahead and make a second coat of lavender on his face. Make sure that first coat is dry. Use your blow dryer if you need to. Let's mix up some green for the cactus. I have 3 dabs of blue and 1 big dab of yellow, and I'm going to mix that up really good for the first coat on the cactus. I'm going to use this yellow and paint the whole cactus green. That's my first layer of green that I'm going to do. Now I need to tackle the inside of that mouth. I'm going to show you, you can use this brush to do really, really small areas. I've got blue on my brush. If you want to use pink because it makes more sense, you go ahead. The reason why I use blue is because if I have a color of paint somewhere in a painting, I want at least another area to have that same color. And I was beginning to run out of choices, and I had to do something blue somewhere. So I went ahead and did the mouth. And I really like it because that blue is a cooler color and it's going to sit back into his mouth, you know, because the inside of the mouth is farther back. And that orange and that yellow are brighter colors that are going to come forward a little bit. So the blue makes sense, even though a purple llama doesn't make sense. I'm going to go back to my cactus. I'm going to mix some of that blue that was on the edge into a little bit of my green. And I want this for a shadow area. Now, where the 2 smaller ones touch the bigger ones, I'm going to have a little bit of a shadow right there that I want to do. And I don't go all the way up. I just make a little bit of area, as you can see. Next, I'm going to go to the bottom part of the cactus and do the same thing on the little tiny one and the main part of the cactus. I'm also going to go on the left side of the cactus part, you'll see. And I'm just kind of thinking about that sun is over there on the left side, but I'm imagining that the llama is kind of shading that side of the cactus, so that's why I put that there. This is where we make that hair pink. Now, since I kept the highlights, I'm just leaving some of that yellow to show on the left-hand side where I'm thinking the sun is going to touch it. Now, if you've gotten the yellow on there and you also think, nah, I don't like this, just cover all of the yellow up, because you are going to need more than one coat of this paint. So that yellow just acts as a second coat, and now this is your third coat, so you can have nice bright pink hair. Once you have all of this hair done the way you like it, go ahead and put another coat of pink on those little things on the cactus. I think that's where the blooms come out, but I don't know if they have a name or not. I'm sure they do. I'm going to use the black paint to do the pupil part of his eye, but if you want to use that Sharpie, you can use the Sharpie. It's not going to be that big of a deal. It won't make that much of a difference. And if this small little area intimidates you, and especially because you kind of want to really keep it round, go ahead and use the Sharpie. No big deal. Now, this is a crazy llama, so if your pupils get a little bit off, they're not both the same roundness, don't worry about it. He's gonna look like he has even more character if his pupils are different sizes. We're gonna go and mix some paint up for the green part of his eyes. Now, again, like with that blue, I wanted green in another place. That's why I chose the green in this particular area. And you can see that I put some yellow in that green that I already have, because I want that green that's in his eyes to be even brighter than the green in the cactus. Mix yourself up a really good bright green. Now that we got that mix, we're going to go straight into that eye area, being careful and just using the tip of that brush in that tight corner. Like I said, you can go ahead and go to a smaller brush, but I don't think you're going to need to. This is a color that you're probably going to have to do more than one coat, so remember, let it dry and then put the second coat on. Don't use a lot of paint on this first coat. Make it nice and thin. It'll be streaky and it's going to be hard not to put more paint on there. You saw that I turned it over. Always turn it over to a direction that's more comfortable to you to paint. If you're getting ridges on your edges, that means you're putting too much paint on your paintbrush. Let's do a little bit of dry brushing. What's dry brushing? You'll see. I've got that dark purple. It's nice and dry now. And I've got the lavender on my brush. But it's like I'm putting a little bit of paint on my brush and wiping the majority of it off. I just want to get a little bit of lighter color on his neck, and I kind of do it in this, I don't know, V pattern. And the V is more the dark color, so I'm doing it inside out in a way. And I'm just brushing it on there. I'm not trying to cover everything up. It's going to kind of look like fur. Here we go, we're almost to the finish line. I have my paintbrush and I'm getting a little bit of white on there. Don't put too much on there. And I'm using it vertically again. It's almost perpendicular to the canvas because I want a thin stroke. And there's no necessarily rhyme or reason where I'm putting these highlights, but I like to go on curved edges. Why don't you just sit back and watch me paint? A trick here to keep that line thin, don't push so hard on it. Just barely skim over it. If it's not enough, just do it again. Now we're ready to take care of the sides. Probably got a little bit of blue on there when you were doing that wash. I have my sponge brush. You probably wondered if we were going to use that again. And I'm just going down, see how I go on the edge there. I don't go too far over into the picture part of the canvas. And I just do some little tiny strokes down. Then I go to the next area and I make a straight line with the edge of that brush and I pull it all down. You don't want a lot of paint on this either. I only did one coat because we're gonna do something else in a sec. I've let that paint on the edge dry, but I'm going back in and doing that course correction that I told you about and doing those ears in that purple. I just think it looks better. If you like it yellow, by all means, keep it yellow. It's your painting. Now for the fun part, we're gonna make this painting come to life. I'm gonna get everything outlined. I've backed up the camera so you can actually see me working on that sun. And we're just gonna slowly outline it. You don't need real hard pressure. If you have a lighter pressure, your line will be like just a little bit, you know, lighter. If you have a hard pressure, you're going to push down on that nib and you'll probably make it even blunter. So that's not really a good idea. Try to be confident in your strokes and then they won't be so jagged. See how I did those, that hair? I did that little kind of sideways V. Always look where you want to go, not where you're going. It's so much easier that way. Make sure you turn your painting instead of your body like I'm doing there to make it a lot easier in the direction that your hand wants to go. There I go, now I turn the painting. If I stop in the middle of those, I might get a little bit of a jaggy line. If you do stop, make sure you're really careful about where you put your pen back down, that you start just a little bit into an area that you've already got black. And this will make a smoother transition. If you don't have perfect edges with your paint, this black's gonna go right over it so you have a nice smooth edge. That's the beauty of these pens. They make everything just come right together and you don't have to be perfect. Once you get to the area around those whites of the eyes, you do want to be careful. You want a nice curve line. You don't want anything jaggy. Also, if you want to fix up those black pupils, if you painted them and you don't have them exactly the way you want them, go ahead and use some black in those pupils. Even things out if you want things evened out. Fix your mistakes with it. I'm not gonna have you watch me do my whole outline. You just outline yours and have some fun. I'll catch you up on the other side. Okay, you caught me. I forgot the side of the face. I do outline that later on. I see that. On that cactus there, you can see I'm making a little prickly spine. I'm just doing a V shape and just a little dash, vertical dash line. You could make like little X's or little X stars, you know, how you do an X and then you do a couple more lines. Any way you want to make those spikes or those little pokey things on the cactus. Let's finish up the sides with some pizzazz. Take your sponge brush, put some black paint on it, and we're just gonna make some little stripes. The way I figure out the width is I take the brush and I kind of put it over that one, the area that I'm not gonna be painting in, and I'm going to keep my eyeball there and then paint another stripe. Go all the way to the end of this. You'll have a little bit of odd space at the end, but that's okay. Did your Lionel Llama turn out? Leave me a comment in the below. Tell me what you did different. Tell me what you wish I would have done. Go ahead and like that by hitting that like button.